Land, water, and pasture. These are the issues. These are the resources that are at the heart of the conflict between crop-growing farmers and cattle-tending herders. For more than a century, this dispute existed on a controllable scale with local conflict resolution channels available to both groups, leading to mutual coexistence. But in the past two decades, the tension has become more ferocious and violent on an increasing scale. The fact that other sub-Saharan African countries across the Sahel, such as Mozambique, Tanzania, Ghana, Mali, and Kenya, experience similar tensions, tell us that this problem isn't a recent matter, but has wider dimensions that needs comprehensive policy attention. But first understand that when the issues are colored by religious and ethnic stamps, people fail to see that there's a climate change issue of desertification and a resultant flurry to river sources. Or they fail to see that a growing population needs more food, hence more land to grow crops and more livestock to grace the tables. So while the federal government introduces policies to address the source issues of land, water, and pasture, and the compound issues of security, conflict resolution, humanitarian assistance to the displaced, climate change, and food security, we must realize that this hydra-headed issue isn't a creation of today or the past couple of years. It's been brewing for decades, and understanding it for what it is and what it is not is the first step to working it out.